History in Analogies. Hitler often referred to Enver Pasha, and this fact speaks for itself. He was ruthless to those he considered enemies, while he saw enemies not only in individuals, but in entire nations. No wonder the name itself, Enver Pasha, provokes ire of millions of people. Sanitizer or precursor of Nazism. Nevertheless, it is not for nothing that the truth is considered to be learned by comparison. For example, Hitler is compared with many figures. He's become some sort of a unit of measurement of evil. However, drawing parallels between Hitler and Enver Pasha is perfectly tenable, and here's why. In 1923, Adolf Hitler was trialed in Germany for attempting a coup d'etat in Munich. The future Führer built his defense speech, referring mainly to Enver Pasha and Benito Mussolini. These two men were exemplary for him in promoting the ideas of nationalism. The words Enver Pasha sanitized the country can be considered to be apotheosis of his speech. Hitler was referring to Enver Pasha's ethnic cleansing in Turkey. Later, when the Nazis took over the power, Führer put this tactic into practice. The truth is, however, that he sanitized not only Germany, but also Europe, and was planning to do the same with the entire world. So, it becomes obvious why Hitler sympathized with Enver Pasha, while Enver had a similar appeal to Germany in general. His admiration took shape when in 1876, the Pasha went on a diplomatic mission to Berlin and took its final form in 1909, when he was appointed military attaché in Berlin and stayed there for two more years. Enver Pasha became a convinced germophilist, deeply influenced by the years spent in Germany. Needless to mention, he was most impressed by the discipline, level of training, and equipment of the German army. He also walked away with certain conclusions. Indeed, tell me who your idol is, and I will tell you who you are. Who was Hitler's idol? Enver Pasha. Ismail Enver was born on November 22, 1881 in Istanbul, in a family of a railway worker. After graduating from primary and secondary school, he enrolled at a military lyceum in Monastir. Enver completed his military education at the Military Academy of the General Staff, which he graduated from in 1903 with the rank of captain. His service, or rather his career, began shortly after. It was a quick way up of a man who would go all lengths. He demonstrated this when in January 1913, backed up with like-minded people, he carried out a coup d'etat, which led to the overthrow of the government. Now, how can we not go back to comparisons again? Remember Hitler's Beer Hall Putsch in Munich? It is true that Hitler, then still little known, was arrested and sentenced to 5 years imprisonment. As for Enver Pasha, the coup d'etat was more than successful, at least for him personally. After the shift of power, a military dictatorship was established in Turkey. It was led by an informal triumvirate of three pashas, Talat, Enver, and Jamal. Enver Pasha took the post of Minister of War. And here again, one cannot do without comparative parallels. After the failed putsch, Hitler wrote his masterpiece, Mein Kampf. While following his success at the coup d'etat, Enver began to actively promote the ideology of Pan Turkism and Pan Islamism. The idea of a chosen people, meant to dominate over other nations, was woven through both conceptions. Watch this video to find out Enver ended up no better than Hitler. How Hitler implemented his doctrine of a chosen people in practice is well known to all. It is imprinted in history how he involved the whole world and all peoples in war, making the world experience it firsthand. Jews were the Führer's pet project. Meanwhile, Enver's pet project carried more of a religious character. And no wonder, for he was one of the prisoners of the political project, Turan Yolu, Road to Turan, that is, Pan-Turkish ideology, assuming Turkey should be the core of the new superpower. Needless to say, Christians appeared to be the main obstacle on the roadmap. Enver Pasha ardently supported the idea of eradicating Christian population in the Ottoman Empire, so as soon as an opportunity came up, he embraced his plan with vigor. It is worth noting, however, that neither Enver nor his adherent Adolf Hitler waited for the opportunity. They created opportunities instead. And so, using the usurped power, Enver Pasha got the ball rolling. And so that no one would doubt his endowment with a special mission, he ordered to engrave the following inscription on his personal seal: Commander-in-Chief of all the armies of Islam, son-in-law of the Caliph and representative of the Prophet. Representative of a Prophet. You feel the tone, don't you? As such, in tandem with Talat Pasha and Jamal Pasha, he embarked on the first act of creating the Great Tehran. This triumvirate actually ruled in Turkey, organized the genocide of Armenians, Pontic Greeks, and Assyrians in the Ottoman Empire. As a result, more than 1 million people were killed. By the way, Jamal Pasha, being a plenipotentiary military and civilian administrator of Syria, aggravated the population so badly that it responded him with the Arab Revolution led by Sheriff Hussein and his sons. In addition, Jamal Pasha participated in the Arab massacres in Levant. It appeared that the Christians were not the only obstacle on the way to Tehran. So, in midst of the global chaos caused by World War I, the atrocities of the Turkish triumvirate remained unnoticed. However, in 1918, after Turkey signed the Armistice of Mudros, retribution came to him. And not somewhere, but in the homeland of triumvirs. After the war, all members of the triumvirate were sentenced to death by a military tribunal. However, they were trailed in absentia because all the three managed to escape to Germany, so that the sentence was not carried out. However, it was only a matter of time. Each member of the bloody triumvirate got what they deserved. Talat Pasha and Jamal Pasha were killed by Armenian Avengers. Enver Pasha was killed in a battle with Bolsheviks in Central Asia. Certainly, the format requires completion of the line of comparison between Enver Pasha and Hitler, but perhaps looking at Turkey today, a fresher analogy springs up. Should we know and remember such people to prevent repeating of history? If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more videos in World Made Men series. Thank you for watching.